Have you ever wondered who Melchizedek is and what do they mean by the order of Melchizedek? Stay tuned. We're going to look in the scripture. We're going to pull out some books and some verses, and we're going to show you exactly who they are. Hey y'all, Coach in the Fight here, looking at some comments that I got from a couple of viewers. One in particular, it's from Love My Brethren as Myself. He says, Coach, have you read about Melchizedek, the order of the Melchizedek? My response was, only a little, a while back, which basically mean, no, I ain't really studied on the guy at all. I basically heard something probably in some video somewhere. Then he goes on to say, the Holy Spirit is leading me to have you do a research on him and then do a teaching maybe on him from what the Spirit shows you. Thank you, sir, again. How about we knock out two birds with one stone? How about I do the research and do the teaching at one time? Yeah, because I don't know where it's going to end up. It may end up, you know, going nowhere. So how about I just record everything, record what I found. You see, he says something else here. And also look up Zadokite priests versus Levitical priests and let us know what you find. Okay, well, we'll do that in another one. Let's look at this Melchizedek first. And let me show you some interesting stuff that I found. Okay, first of all, let's come over here to BibleGateway.com and check out their search engine and let's look up Melchizedek. Now, oddly enough, it only gives us two references for Melchizedek, and I believe it's because it's a misspelling in the word. But let's look right here in Genesis 14 and 18. He says, and Melchizedek, king of Salem, brought forth bread and wine, and he was the priest of the Most High God. Now, that's pretty much all you're going to get about the guy in Genesis or even in the Old Testament, except for, you know, Psalms 110 verse 4 over there, which says, the Lord has sworn and will not repent. Thou art the priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. All right, so that's all we get over there. But if we change the spelling of the word a little bit, we can find another verse on him. So hold on. All right, now if we spell the word a little bit differently, we'll find when he's mentioned in the New Testament. And there's a lot of names like that that are spelled differently in the Old Testament than they are in the New Testament. But we see here that Hebrews chapter 5 talks about Melchizedek. It says, verse 6 says, and he saith unto another place, thou art a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. That's the same thing that Psalm said. Hebrews chapter 5 verse 10 says, called of God the high priest after the order of Melchizedek. And then you get into Hebrew chapter 6 says, whether the forerunner is for us entered, made a high priest for even after the order of Melchizedek. Now, it's not giving us a lot of information so far on Melchizedek until we get to chapter 7. Looks like chapter 7 has a lot to do with Melchizedek in there. Now, so let's look at some of these verses. Maybe we'll go look at the whole chapter. It says, for this Melchizedek, king of Salem, priest of the Most High God, who met Abraham returning from the slaughter of the kings and blessed him. What he's talking about is when these kings, I think it was the king of Sodom, it was about five kings that, you know, were wreaking havoc all over that part of the world. And, you know, they was doing good until they got Abraham's nephew and ticked Abraham off a little bit. And Abraham went and got his nephew back. And, you know, while he was getting his nephew back, he basically destroyed all of those nations or whatever. And this is Melchizedek who came out to meet him. And he blessed him. 7:10 says, for he was yet in the loins of his father when Melchizedek met him. All right, we have to look at that one in context to see who he's talking about. Matter of fact, let's go ahead and look at the whole chapter here so we don't have to keep jumping back and forth. Now, it said, verse 6 said, let's go up to verse 8. And here men that die receive tithes, but there he receiveth them of whom it is witnessed that he liveth. And as I may say, Levi also, who receiveth tithes, pays tithes to Abraham, for he was yet in the loins of his father when Melchizedek met him. All right, so it's talking about Levi paying tithes to Abraham I guess because Melchizedek wasn't really around anymore. And we're going to find a little more information on that here in a second. Let's continue verse 7. He says, "If therefore perfection were by the Levitical priesthood, for under it the people received the law, what further need was there that another priest should arise after the order of Melchizedek and not be called after the order of Aaron?" All right, now, Aaron was a different kind of priest, mainly because there was a different kind of thing going on. You got to remember that the Father came down. A lot of people call that the very first coming, even before Yehoshua HaMashiach came down and made himself flesh. People point back to when he came down and was in that tent speaking, talking about the Father speaking face to face with Moses, that was actually the first coming of first coming of our Father and or first coming of our Savior, and so that created a whole different type of priesthood, and that's what he's talking about there. All right, now come on down here to verse 15. He says, "And it is yet far more evident, for that after the similitude of Melchizedek there arises another priest who is made not after the law of the carnal commandment, but after the power of the endless life." Now, this is talking about the Messiah here. This is talking about Yehoshua HaMashiach and comparing his ministry to the first ministry. "For he testifies, thou art the priest forever after the order of Melchizedek." Then down here is, "The Lord swear and will not repent, thou art a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek." And that's all we hear pretty much about Melchizedek in the Bible, in the New Testament, anywhere in the Bible. Let's go back and make sure. Yeah, so that's basically all that the word, or all that the King James Version tells us about Melchizedek. But, you know, there are other books that we can look at, and there was one book in particular that I did go look at because I seem to remember, and my wife verified it, that Melchizedek is actually mentioned in the book of Jasher. I did a search for, and you guys, you know, pick up some of these tips and stuff on how to find some of these hidden books. You can get a lot of free information off the web. But so I put in jasher.pdf, and I got this here coming from holybooks.com, and when I click on it, it's actually the whole book of Jasher. It's the whole thing, 405 pages, and it's all of it. And so what I'm going to do is go ahead and download it to my computer and save it. But in the meantime, I started searching for Melchizedek, and there were zero hits. And even when I go back and look at how it's spelled the other way, with a K, or a Z, I should say, there are zero hits. Now, I almost gave up at that point, but you know, the Father, you know, inspired me to look at the word Salem. And so I look up the word Salem, and there are actually two or five hits for the word Salem. And I'm looking here, I'm looking, and the first thing that jumps out is Jerusalem, which you do know that Jerusalem and Salem is the same thing. All of the cities in America that's named Salem is actually short for Jerusalem. It's actually the same word, you know, it's just truncated a little bit. We call it Salem, but it's actually Jerusalem, and that jumped out at me. And then I see here the word Abraham, and you know, Jerusalem and the king, and I'm starting to think there's a relationship here. So then I look on a little closer, and I see down here, the second time I see the word Salem, it says, it's talking about the king of Jerusalem, and it says he went out with men to meet Abraham and his people with bread and wine, and they remained together in the valley. Now, that was really interesting, because over here, if you look back at Genesis 14 and 18, it says that this Melchizedek, king of Salem, or Jerusalem, brought forth bread and wine, and he was the priest of the Most High God. So now I'm starting to look and see, maybe these are the same. So let's look back a little closer at this verse. It says, instead of Melchizedek, it says Adonizedek, king of Jerusalem, the same with Shem, went out with his men to meet Abram and his people with bread and wine, and they remained together in the valley of Melech. So now I see that they're using this word right here. Instead of Melchizedek, they're using Adonizek, but this is actually Melchizedek right here. And turns out, who is he? He's Shem. Shem. And if you remember who Shem was one of the sons that got off the boat with Noah. Noah had three sons on the boat: Shem, Japheth, and Ham. Shem is actually the father of the Shemites, or you know, the seed from where Abraham came. Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob came from Shem. Now, this is saying, the way I see this, Melchizedek is the same as Adonizedek, Adonai, that's the first word of that, but Adonizedek are the same, and they are Shem, which would have been Abraham's granddaddy. And looking a little bit closer here, we see that Shem was actually alive during the time of Abraham. Noah was too when he was a child, but it appears here that Shem actually lived until Abraham was over 100 years old when he received the covenant. And when we come over and look up the word Adonai, we see it's the Hebrew word for God. And so that's what they mean by the Most High God, which we understand Melchizedek means priest of the Most High God. Well, Adonizek would also mean the priest of the Most High God. And we see over here that Melchizedek was the king of Salem in Genesis chapter 14, and he's bringing bread and wine to bless Abram. And we see over back in the book of Jasher that Shem or Adonizek went out to meet Abram with bread and wine. So this is clear that it's talking about the exact same guy here. Melchizedek is Adonizek, who is Shem, Abraham's granddaddy, to the eighth degree. So there you have it. And I believe that the main lesson that we learn here is that we actually need all of our father's scripture. There are many people out there who would love to know who Melchizedek was, but they will only do so when they start to recognize the book of Jasher. As long as they deny the book of Jasher, then they won't know who Melchizedek is, and for some of them, that's to their benefit because they can just make it up. Well, I recognize the book of Jasher, and I think you should too. It's actually a very awesome book full of knowledge, wisdom, and understanding written by Moses. So look for a link down in the description of this video, or if you wanted to, you can look on YouTube where they have full audiobooks of the Book of Jasher. But whichever version you decide to look at, let me tell you to actually look for superheroes in this book. You'll find out that the children of Israel had powers that today we attribute to superheroes. In fact, there was a video I saw a long time ago, and I can't find it now, where somebody compared the modern day fictional comic superheroes to the children of Israel as written in the book of Jasher, claiming that that's where they got it from, and I believe it's true. So check out the book of Jasher. And in the meantime, go ahead and hit that like button if you got something out of this video, and leave us a comment. Shalom.